Hello everyone, this is Kalyan, and in today's episode, I will show you how to use other schematic inside your schematic and generate files from your templates. Also, I will show you how to take input from users and pass those as template variable. So without further ado, let's get started. The setup is same as our last tutorial, so I'm not going to into much details. If you want a refresher, please check my basic schematic tutorial. Mainly, we'll perform a step like this. We'll install Angular Universal Schematics. Then, we will add additional package dependencies, install them, add our files from our template, and we'll add some packagejson scripts. We have added a new file called schema.json, which holds properties which we will be going to collect from user. The first one is path for server-side route config file. We have added a default path, and if someone wants a different path, they can override this value using path equal to whatever URL they want. Also, we have added an alias or short form they can use as P. The next one is the name of the client app based on which our server-side configs will generate. And we made this as a mandatory input by making this as required field, without which it will not work. We'll be using a prompt within command line to get the value from user. And the last one is a base URL. This also have a default value, which is project name. Let's create our first function. As I told you earlier, that the first thing we'll do is to use the Angular Universal Schematics, which can be used from external schematic method, and also we will pass some required input to that from our user input. For an example, client project name and app ID. Let's import the missing modules. I will add these arg options from our schema.json, which points to our schema interface. The next function we'll add, which will add some required package.json dependencies and also install that. I am using a package called Schematic Utilities, which is a wrapper for Angular Schematic and comes with very handy utilities functions. Let's import that. We have added all our required package dependencies in this array along with version, and then using foreach loop and with help of @packagejson dependency method, we are adding all dependencies into our package.json. The next function we'll use, which will install all the added dependencies using our node package install task method, which can be found under schematics task. Let's import that. let's uncomment that from our default function. To run the application, we need some scripts to be added to our package.json, which will build the app and run. Let's add a function which we will do exactly that. This function reads the package.json, and within script block, it will add all the defined script for us. Now, the next important function is to add the files from our templates, which is inside our files directory. Within this directory, we have webpack server config, which will be used to build our server.ts file. Then we have server.ts file. In this file, we have added some template variables which will be coming from the user's input and for which the configuration stored in the schema.json. For an example, this name variable will be the name of the client-side app with a dash server suffix. Same for the routes, it will take default input from schema if user don't pass anything. Let's add the function and import the missing modules. This function is basically getting all the files from files directory and passing argument options from user and generating or adding the files in the project directory. One thing to remember, the folder structure should be the same the way you want to be placed in the project directory. Let's uncomment this function as well. Let's build the schematics using npm run build. Now, if you run, you can see the prompt which will ask user to provide the name of the client application. But once you add that, the next steps will not work as it will look for an Angular project named testdev. So now let's use these schematics in a real scenario. This time I will use npm pack to make an npm package as a tar file and use that in our Angular app. As you can see, a tar file has been generated on the name of the package.json name. Now generate a Angular CLI app. I'm giving a name of test app. The expectation here, if we run our schematic inside this project, this project should configure as an universal app. I will install our schematic tar file with relative path. But if you published in npm, then it will be straightforward. Now, once our schematic installed, then we can run that using our ng add command. Now, it will ask for the client project name. In our case, it is testdev. And that's it. It will generate all the files and will configure the application as a universal application.